What does Guru Purnima mean to me? Broadly, I appreciate it in three terms. First is, we understand that all of us, whatever we learn, if we want to learn it seriously, we need a guide. And Guru Purnima is the time when we acknowledge our debts to our guides. In my childhood, the people who inspired me the most, apart from my parents, were my teachers. In fact, one of my fondest aspirations was to become some kind of teacher. And now, while we have different kinds of teachers, the teachers who teach us not about specific areas and specific skills in life, but who teach us about life itself, the meaning and purpose of life, those teachers are the most important. And Vyasadev, who is the foremost guru, who is the teacher of all teachers in the dharmic traditions, the seat on which a speaker sits is sanctified and is called as a Vyasasana. The idea is asana is seat, Vyasa is the seat of Vyasa. So we all, if we share spiritual wisdom, we pray for the blessings of Vyasadeva. We act as representatives of Vyasadeva. In fact, he is called a Vyasadeva. Deva means a godly being. So the Vyasadeva has written a vast variety of literature through which he has taught all of humanity for all time to come. And he has given a breathtaking breadth of material knowledge. And he has also demonstrated through his own life, as depicted in the Bhagavatam, how every kind of material expertise is exhilarating in some ways, but is ultimately exhausting, disappointing. So even the person who is considered to be the greatest teacher learns from his teacher, that is Narad Muni, about how life's ultimate purpose is not just to gain expertise in various fields of knowledge in this world, but to learn about the ultimate reality, that is God, Krishna, and to develop our devotion for him and to help others develop their devotion for him. The deepest longing of the human heart is to love and be loved. And Vyasadeva brings the summum bonum, the climax of all the knowledge that he has assimilated and shared in the Srimad Bhagavatam, which is essentially a guidebook, a description of divine love, of bhakti. How different people face different challenges in lives, and by taking shelter of the Lord through bhakti, transcended those challenges. So, Vyasadeva is the person whom we remember and revere on the occasion of Guru Purnima. That is the second significance. So, the third is my personal spiritual master. For us to grow seriously in our spiritual life, we need a living teacher. The one who thinks that I will be my own guru has a fool as a disciple. So we all need a person whom we can see, with whom we can interact, from whom we can hear, who can inspire us by words and examples of how we can live a life of higher consciousness, higher values, how we can learn to love God and we can help others to love God. So, these three memories of the various teachers I had during my education, of the original teacher, Vyasadeva, who has given a wealth of spiritual wisdom as his legacy for all of humanity, and my personal guru, who has guided me on my spiritual journey. These are the three celestial, three personalities or three sets of persons that make Guru Purnima immensely significant for me. And I pray that I always keep getting guidance during my life journey, and in my own small way, whatever guidance I have got, I try to share with others. Thank you.